guys, it's Brian here. So today I'm back with one of my true crime type of videos. And before I forget, I just want to say, by making this video, I don't mean any disrespect whatsoever to the victim who will be talking about, his family, his friends, or anything like that. I'm not making this video in any way to be disrespectful. I really just want to make this video to try to get his name out, to try to get more coverage and information shared about this case. So yeah, I don't really want to do a long intro, so let's just get into this video. Also, I always do this. I just want to say, I'm human, I make mistakes, I make errors. If I make any mistakes or anything, feel free to correct me down below. Or if you have more information that I did not come across, please feel free to share that down below, so more people can be more aware and, who knows, maybe possibly help solve this case one day. So yeah, without further ado, again, let's get into this video. So today we're going to be talking about an actual child. He was actually a childhood actor, and his name was Joseph David Wolfgang Pichler. There is an H in his last name. I've watched a few videos, and some people say Pichler, some people say Pichler. I'm just going to go with Pichler, but if that's wrong, let me know down below, like I mentioned at the beginning of this video. So Joseph was born February 14th, 1987. He was described by his family as a good kid, and he never really got in trouble, or he never really ran away. He was just an overall pretty good kid. He was actually the fourth of five children in his family, and he relocated when he was about 6 years old to LA to pursue an acting career. He was one of the lucky ones, and he actually did have a bit of success. He appeared in several movies and television series. He was probably best known for his reoccurring role as Brennan Newton in the third and fourth installments of the Beethoven movies. They were basically just family-oriented comedies about the antics of a mischievous St. Bernard. So like I mentioned before, he actually moved out to LA when he was 6 years old, but he actually returned to his hometown of Bremerton, which is in Washington, in 2003. And he actually graduated from high school there in 2005. Apparently though, when he did move back to his hometown, he wasn't really excited about it. He liked the LA living. I think he liked how he had more opportunities in LA to possibly get more roles in that. But he did eventually settle in comfortably, and he was happy to be back. He also actually received a bunch of money from a trust fund after turning, I believe it was 18 years old. And with that money, and his acting money, I'd assume, he actually ended up getting his own residence away from his family, even though they apparently were frequent visitors to his house. And honestly, I think that's awesome. Like, he was 18 years old and he had his own house. Like, goals. Like, he clearly was accomplished and had a lot going for him. But that being said, even though he did have his own residence, which I believe was across town from his parents and his brother and sister, he did intend to return back to LA. He did intend to move back to LA in the following year. I believe he also was going to be getting his braces off within the following year. And so he was excited for that to happen, and I feel like he felt like he'd have a better chance of getting some more roles without having braces on his teeth. So 2 months before Joe actually went missing, he took up a full-time job. He was a telephone technician at Teletech. He was a tech person for Nextel and another phone company. I also saw reports, I didn't see these everywhere, but I'm just gonna include it just in case this could mean something. I saw reports that said he was experimenting with drugs and alcohol recreationally. I'm not sure how true that is, since some reports mentioned it, others didn't. So do with that information as you will. So that's basically all the background information I could really find about him. There really wasn't too much. Obviously, like, I could go into more detail about the television series he was in and the movies, but I think I want to more focus just on his disappearance and that. And so at the time of his disappearance, he was actually 19 years old, and he was actually 6'2" tall, so he was a pretty tall guy. And the last report they have of how much he weighed was 170 pounds. He had light brown hair and hazel green eyes. He was also wearing metal braces, like I mentioned earlier. They had black rubber bands only on the top row of his teeth, because he actually didn't have any braces at the bottom on the bottom row of his teeth. I guess he got them removed sooner. His teeth straightened out better at the bottom, and the braces were actually set to be removed a month or two after his disappearance. He also has a circular tattoo of a red Star Wars emblem on the inside of his right forearm, and he has a small scar across the bridge of his nose. So Joseph was actually last seen on January 5th, 2006. So 13 years ago now. The day he went missing, he was actually hanging out with his friends. They were playing cards, and his friends stated that he was actually in good spirits that evening. I saw on one website, though, that said as the night progressed, his mood changed, one of his friends said, but I only ever read that once, so I'm not sure how accurate that information is. So no one's seen him after that evening of playing cards with his friends on January 5th, but on January 9th, 2006, his car, which was a silver 2005 Toyota Corolla, was found. It was at the intersection of Whedon Way and Sheridan Road. His family then officially reported him missing on January 16th after not hearing from him. According to his family statements to the media at the time, the last outgoing call on his cell phone was placed at 4:08 a.m., on January 5th, to a friend who then said that Joe was actually visiting them earlier in the day. I'm not really sure what happened in this phone call, because 4 a.m. is either very early or very late to get a phone call from someone just to say hello or anything like that, but I couldn't find out what the phone call entailed. So I'm not sure when his apartment was searched, but when his apartment was checked out and that it was found unlocked and with the lights were on, which was reportedly really uncharacteristic of Joe. Also, all of Joe's belongings were left behind, except for his car keys and wallet. Speaking of his wallet, I couldn't find any information if any of his credit cards or anything have ever been used, like his social insurance number or anything like that, has been used since his disappearance. I also watched a video, I believe his sister was speaking in the video, and they were talking about how his younger brother found his car. And at the time, they found a black glove right beside it, but they didn't really think anything of it. They didn't touch it. They didn't think it was related to the case. If I can or if I remember, I'll try to link that video down below. So that's basically all the information I could really find on Joe's case. There is a little bit more that I'll go into, but other than that, I really didn't find much more. So if you have any more additional information or if I made any mistakes, please feel free to leave it down below to share and help with his story. So Joe is actually considered to be in danger, though some poetry he left behind may have indicated that he actually was feeling really depressed. He stated that he wished he had been a stronger brother for his younger brother and asked that his belongings go to his brother. However, there is no hard evidence that he took his own life, and Joe's writings did not explicitly state that he ever had any actual intentions of doing so. And like I mentioned earlier in this video, the day that he went missing, his friends said that he was in good spirits. But his family does not believe he was depressed or suicidal at the time of his disappearance. They believe that he has probably met with some foul play. Police have theorized, though, that Joe may have committed suicide by jumping off a bridge and that he jumped into the Port Madison Narrows, but search dogs did not trace his scent to the bridge. And yeah, I don't know, it is just like, it's such a different case. Like, I think it's kind of crazy how he was a childhood actor in that and he lived in LA, but I feel like this case hasn't got much coverage, and that's why I wanted to make this video. Because you think that someone that was an actor would kind of, his information would be spread everywhere and there would be so much information and the police would be working hard to solve the case. Even though I know this is an older case and that it did happen in 2006. But still, I'm just surprised by like the lack of coverage and information and that there is out there. And yeah, so I just really wanted to share Joe's story with everyone. I really was just like, I'm hoping that this video does something. I will leave the Bremerton Police Department number linked down below in case you do have any additional information. Anything, no matter how small or how minor you may think it is, it could help open up this case and create new leads or anything like that. So I'll definitely link that down below. But yeah, I don't know. I just really wanted to get his story out there. To me, I don't usually like giving opinions because I know opinions, not everyone likes to hear them. But for his case, I just really don't know. I think it's interesting how there was kind of depressing notes and that found in his house. But I just don't know if I believe that he committed suicide. I don't know, like he spent the day with his friends and for the most part his friends said he was in good spirits and that. So I just don't know why he'd want to end his life then. And like he wanted to go back to LA to try to get some more acting opportunities and that. And like he clearly was doing good for himself for an 18-year-old young man. Like he had his own house, he had experience with acting, and that definitely helps getting more experience. And then like there's better odds of you getting more acting jobs and acting calls than that. So I just don't know. That being said, a lot of childhood actors do kind of come out and speak about depression and that, and the pressure and all that. And the pressure and all that like comes with the acting industry and that. So like I said, I don't know, this case just really leaves me unsettled and I just don't know how to feel. But yeah, like I said at the beginning of this video, I don't mean any disrespect in any shape, way, or form. I'm just making a video using information I found online and trying to get a story out there. And like I said, if I made any mistakes or anything, or if I somehow offended anyone, I'm sorry. And yeah, there's something else I wanted to say and now I don't remember what it is, and now I feel like I'm gonna regret. But if you guys have any more case suggestions or anything like that, feel free to leave them down below. I'll definitely look up cases and that. I hope you guys are having a great day or had a great day, and I'll see you in my next video. Bye guys.